worked under the Soviet Union, and capitalism has not really worked for them. And, you know, you are not a socialist in the sense that everything has to be socialist. You're like every other modern, intelligent country in this world, quasi-socialist. Capitalism works for most things, but some things should be off-limits to the profit mixer. Healthcare, prisons, I would say covering the elections themselves. So can't we just make that case that capitalism?
Look, number one, the greed of Wall Street in corporate America is such that there is now a profound anger against the top 0.1% who appear to want a ball and could care less about the investors. But the second point that you're making is that I think most Americans understand that in the year 2016, it is not a radical idea to say that public colleges and universities should be tuition-free, that the wealthy and large corporations should start paying their fair share of taxes.
State universities used to be.
That's exactly right.
It's not like we're doing something that new.
No, that's right. We're going back to where we were 50 years ago.
Right.
Is it a radical idea to say that the United States should join the rest of the industrialized world, every other country, and guarantee health care for all of our people as a right? I don't think so. Is it a radical idea to say that we should not have a corrupt campaign finance system in which billionaires buy elections? I don't think so. So your point is well taken. Look, entrepreneurship, etc., creates a lot of good things in this country and a lot of wealth. But the American people are entitled to know that they're going to have health care, education, decent housing. The basic needs of life should be there for all of our people.
Bernie Sanders, everybody.